Rasmussen. He's 6 years of age, so he'll turn 27 this next Monday, Monday the 17th, the day after the Thomas Cup final. Chosen as first men's doubles, but they are in fact the second ranked Indonesian pair in the world ranking. Ranked number seven, but behind, sorry, they're ranked number eight, one place behind Lula Adianto and Yulianto Elvin. But of course, the top ranked Indonesian pair lost in the group match to China, to Kai Yun and Fu Haifeng, and then of course lost in the quarter final on Wednesday to Chuntan Foot and Lee Wan Wah in two straight games. So Adianto and Elvin not on their best form, and that perhaps one of the reasons why they've selected this Indonesian pair to play at number one.
I think that's one of the reasons, Jill. Also the experience of Flandy and Eng. I think they've played the pair before three times, and I think on all three occasions they've come up trumps.
So that's a heck of a psychological advantage. Never been beaten by their Danish opponents.
And of course now they're playing them in their own backyard with their own crowd behind them. So it's even more of a task for the Danes.
And in fact, the last time they played each other was very recently in the Japan Open. Just a few weeks ago, they met each other in the quarterfinal. And in fact, the Indonesians won 15-10 in the deciding game. So let's just look at this Indonesian pairing. It's Limpele Flandy. It is the left-hander, world ranking of eight, as I mentioned. Didn't play in the first of the knockout stages against New Zealand. Couldn't play against China also. The Danish pairing, reigning world champions and world ranked number one pair. Lars Borsgaard, 28 years of age. Jonas Rasmussen, 26, born in Aarhus. And that world title in Birmingham last year was only their second ever title together. Their previous one had been the German Open. Suresh Nathu of India, the umpire for this match. Down the Danish men's doubles combination here with the big surprises of the World Championships, winning that gold medal.
Yes, I don't think anyone expected them to win. They came through though, to the delight of a lot of people. Fantastic victory for them. You know what, hats off them to get that title. Underdogs played so well in the tournament throughout.
Yes, in great form at exactly the right moment. In the recent European Championships, in fact, this Danish pair, only a bronze medal. And that may sound a bit odd, because many of us would love to win bronze medals, but obviously when you're world rank number one and world champions, then you expect to also win European champions as well.
Yeah, absolutely, they'll be disappointed. It's a hard act to follow when you're world champions.
Denmark has got this extraordinary men's doubles squad at the moment. Here they are, reigning world champions, and playing that second doubles for them, the reigning All-England champions, Jens Eriksson and Martin Lindborg Hansen.
Yeah, that's why they feel they had such a good chance to reach the final or maybe even win this Thomas Cup. They think it's one of the strongest squads they've ever had.
Well, I think they're probably right. But what may appear good on paper, when you put in the cauldron of heat here in Astora Stadium, Indonesians playing in front of their difficult to overcome, not just your opponents, but, oh goodness me, I'm looking around the stadium, 10,000 people here, absolutely packed. Almost ready for the start of the second match.
Ladies and gentlemen, on the right, Denmark, represented by Lars Master and Rasmussen. On my left, Indonesia, represented by Fendi Limpel and Arm Dier. Indonesia to serve, Fendi to Lars, Lavo, Lek.
So the Danes nearest to us. Because of course they spent a stint living at the National Training Centre in England in Milton Keynes, and of course you know them very well indeed.
Yeah, very nice people. They came and got trying in to help our players out, obviously the double squad, to teach them a little about the training, the different methods the Indonesians use, but great lads.
One more.
And in a way, the story goes that they were allowed to go to England because Indonesia felt that they were perhaps past their best. And then they started to play exceedingly well on the World Tour. And they've now qualified for Indonesia as the second pair for the Olympic Games.
Yeah, that's right. I think Indonesia wasn't sure if they had their day. They had a little break in England. Great to fight. A lot of tournaments in Europe done extremely well. And they're back to one of their best forms ever.
Very consistent pair. Four-time semi-finalists already this year, the Indonesians.
Rally game, just playing the shots at the moment.
Rasmussen serving. Rasmussen with the long hair in the Danish partnership. Leeds at the All England a few years ago. And then the All England final as well. That was in 2002. That's that final to Kimbo Moon and Hartai Khan.
Side to side.
They've got to be a little bit cautious about how much they're on defence now.
Yeah, they've got to be careful. They're trying to drive it across at the moment. But at the moment, Nguyen reading it, and they're playing onto his strength, which is his forehand drive.
Exactly that once more.
Yeah, it's his forehand. That's what they're looking for, this Indonesian pair at the moment. I know the Danish pair don't want to give away the lift, but they have to be careful not to get into the driving game, because I do feel the Indonesian pair are better equipped at all. Jill. Try and mix it up a little bit where if one's a support at the back and he's singling him out on his own, get a smash, get to net and squat down a little bit, but try and keep it back in front. Yeah, they've done well that time.
Steve Pedersen on the left, head coach for the Danish team.
Thank you. expect that from Ong Hyun.
And the limper leg slipping as he lunged from his forehand side.
Well, that was good play from Jonas Rasmussen, though. He didn't go straight down the line. Called it cross court. Red by Flandy, saw the flick coming, moved back very quickly, smashed right back at the server. Vicious shot. Didn't like it, but as you say, no complaint from Indonesian players, so.
Solid, but it needing three or four attempts before the Danes finally putting the stuff away.
Yeah, good play by Lars Korska. Stood his ground at the net. When it's putting that much pressure on upon you, very hard to try and get it over his head.
Seven.
Seven. Seven.
Second serve.
looking at the top of the tape coming over.
Indonesian pairing, Darren, so experienced. This is their seventh year in the World Tour playing together. Compare that to the Danes. And this, they formed their partnership at the beginning of 2002.
Yeah, they do stay so cool under pressure. Nothing very rarely gets to them. They've been in this situation before.
Interesting when Andrew Limpelo first started on the World Tour. He was purely a mixed doubles player. Three times reached the final of the Indonesian Open in mixed doubles.
Eight, 11.
serve. Lou, the smash was going to come at him. Pushed it cross court into the gap. Mistake that time, but my goodness, not much margin for error. I do know that the scores are level, 11-all.
A little bit excited, it came through at the net, all you needed to do was just block it back, keep the rally in play. But he really went for an outrageous winner. I saw Flandy just give him on the tap, steady his hand out as if to say, keep it simple.
Second serve.
He goes for the cross goal, looping it up at the net. A real sitter for the Danish pair.
Brave return of serve.
14-13.
All credit for Lars Borska. Return serve and immediately kept his racket up ready. Makes the second game point. Oh.
Return of serve from Borska, straight down the middle, no chance for Brandy to get out of the way.
That's a great rally, great anticipation, reading of the game from Lars Borska. Thank you. at the side of the court, waving their thunder sticks in the air. Absolutely delighted with their teammates.
Second game, Lovell play.
So with the first game secured, 15-13, the world champions from Denmark, Lars Boskjær and Jonas Rasmussen. The last time that these two pairs met was in the quarterfinal of the Japan Open. And in fact, the Danes won the opening game on that occasion, and so going on to lose to their Indonesian opponents. Very good start for the Danes. Secure the first game, out they come. Four in all, seemingly at the moment. The reasons just looking a little bit backy. The 10,000 crowd and a whole nation here in Indonesia carried on the shoulders of these two men. I think perhaps the pressure is getting to them.
Totally missed hitting the drop shot, got the lift I wanted. Trying that a little bit too hard at the moment. Things aren't going away, they've got to steady the ship. They're still going for the shots, but not quite on balance.
unfortunate from the Danish perspective. Because when they sense, or any player or pair sense that their opponents are struggling, that's when you have a foul on the pressure.
Rhythm. They seem to be on the defence most of the time.
So well to recover the Danish combination and setting it up for the other.
Yeah, they're moving around each other so well at the moment. As you say, keeping the pressure on them, not giving a lift away at all. Not giving the Lebanese a chance to settle. Been moving around each other so well that time they got pulled out. Both came forward for the shot. Rasmussen left it. Horska thought Rasmussen was going back.
Surface.
trying to change their tactics, trying to get the lift. They've been defending for the most part this second game, but in doing so, first the forehand side of Wen Zhang, then switching it to his backhand side. Into the forehand there, then.
In a very commanding position at the moment. Christian Adamata, former world champion in men's doubles. Players are here in Asura Stadium to support these championships, and certainly here to support Indonesia.
Away from the Danes, taking the pace off the shuttle when they need to, coming in very strong. The crowd is starting to get to them a little bit. They're desperately trying to change the game, do something, but nothing's working for them.
And they do need a little bit to spend them to meet the body language.
11-1, Sanso.
Resigned to the fact that Max's match is lost.
Second serve.
that now. They have to start piling the points. And as they continue to pressure on the Danes, Rasmussen is liable to make some errors like that. Sometimes he gets a little too confident. Those the shots that just aren't on.
Better from the Danes, go back to the central shot, keep it down. This one, a loose net shot. Rasmussen has gone a little bit casual.
12-5 seconds.
Yeah, the last four shots that they've lost have come from him. As you said earlier, he's just got a little bit overconfident. He needs to settle back down to it and concentrate on the last few points.
Just a blow. And the Indonesian will feel they're right back in this game.
Crushing in, has a big swing at it, but really back it up, no swing, just let it play off it.
Difference from looking completely out of the match at 1-12 down. Now 7. 7-12. And now perhaps it's the Danes that are getting a little bit twitchy on court.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's the first time the Danes, the last 3 or 4 points, have started believing themselves, ball attacking, convincing the first 12 points.
Simple things, the Danish combination, and keep the formation of one at once. They really are a dominant pair.
Yeah, that's how they play their best.
Magnificent performance by the world champions. Coming into this match, they had never beaten their opponents of today in 3 previous encounters. But today, when it mattered, the Danes, their usual celebration with their teammates,
won by Denmark,
greeted by cheers from the crowd. And the overall tie between Indonesia and Denmark is one match apiece.